They call you Lady Luck, but there is room for doubt. At times you have a very unladylike way of running out. You're on this date with me, the pickings have been lush, and yet before this evening is over, you might give me the brush. You might forget your manners, you might refuse to stay, and so the best that I can do is pray. Luck be a lady tonight. Luck be a lady tonight. Luck, if you've ever been a lady to begin with, luck be a lady tonight. Luck, let a gentleman see how nice a dame you can be. I know the way you've treated other guys you've been with. Luck be a lady with me. A lady doesn't leave her escort. It isn't fair, it isn't nice. A lady doesn't wander all over the room and blow on.
Welcome back, bowling fans. This week in the draft league, week number 10, in the house that Rab built, Dungan Hills, Staten Island. Is it week 11? I'm corrected right here. Week 11, 2 weeks to go. Joe can't wait to get going because he's in the hunt. First place, looking to take it down.
I'm not doing any of the work. The girls are doing all the heavy lifting.
Special shout out to all the podcast listeners out there, the thousands. If, I don't know if you guys know this. This is the highest rated bowling show on the internet today. We have a star-studded group coming in tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't think we've ever had stars like we have tonight.
Like the galaxy, Joe.
But let me just explain real quick why this show was even put together in the first place. Jimmy Clinton, ladies and gentlemen. And Ronnie Z, baby. Semper Fi right here. This show was put together as a celebration of scratch bowling in its purest form. Joe knows all about it. None of this handicap stuff. It comes down to who has more pins, you or me. That's it, right, Mike? Bottom line, couple introductions. Camera number one, also known as the Jerusalem Giant, Matt Kaplowitz, the king of the Middle East. Second up, we have a lot of games in the back of this room, and I bet you all the money in your pockets right now that you've never seen a better-looking bowler than this man right here. The ladies hang on him. Mr. Gorgeous, Kenny Soto.
Tony Orlando.
Mike, look at this guy, Mike. Girls love him. Last but not least, Brooklyn Zone. Staten Island Zone, Joe Calandrillo, the man of two boroughs, also known as, to the bowling world, Joe Cal. Joe, what do we got?
Giuseppe, I just want to say you touched on a key word there, celebration.
Celebration,
like cooling the gang. Last night was a celebration of bowling. Staten Island Bowling Hall of Fame opened its doors to some of our friends, Mike King, who's in the back of the room. with his good friend, Dennis Rigatti, who did a wonderful job inducting Mike, okay? Our guest tonight, who made the trek up from Florida with Dennis, and Bobby Garzon, who I had the pleasure of sitting at the same table with, okay? The Florida connection. My only beef with these guys is, look at the weather they brought. That's all I'm saying. They could have brought better weather. I love them dearly, but next time you got to bring at least like 75, 70. We needed a heat wave. We wanted to get out and play some golf. That's not going to happen. But it was a celebration. Staten Island Bowling Hall of Fame opened its doors. Mr. Gorgeous's wife, Mrs. Gorgeous, was inducted. Joanne Soto. Joanne, congratulations. So, Kevin Rourke, our very own.
Our very own, Kevin Rourke.
And Ray did a great job inducting him. Gave a very heartfelt speech, okay?
Did you see the length of that
speech? I saw the length of that speech. He condensed it. He did a great job, as did Dennis. And there's a lot of stories in the back of that room right here. And it's my pleasure and privilege to bring up one of the all-time best that the tri-state area has ever seen.
Ever.
From back in the day. And I remember him when, from Maple Lanes and Brooklyn and Rainbow and all that stuff. Mr. Bob Spallone, coming up from Florida. Come on in, Bob. Pleasure. Bob's a big fan of the show.
Thank you, Joe. First thing I want to say is these guys do a great, great job of this show. I watch it every week, and you can't beat it.
Thank you, Bobby.
But
thank
really, you do a great job.
Thank you.
We are very happy to have you up here. We're happy to have Dennis and Mike sitting in the back of the room. They don't want an on-camera appearance, but they're getting one right now. Right on cue, Kenny and Matt turned around and got them. Right on cue. But, Bob, it was a very nice evening, and it was made better that we had so many good friends and the stories and the revelry. And I used the key word, Joe. I said there was a bevy of bowlers in the room last night, a bevy. And we were abound with a bevy of bowlers. But it was a great night. So tonight is a continuation of that. We're going to touch on some old school bowling. And the first question I have for my friend Bob is, Bob, back in the day when you first started bowling, this is a two-part question, who was it that got you into the sport, and where was the first place that you bowled?
My father got me into the sport. He used to bowl Sunday mornings. Excuse me. And I used to go to watch him. I think I was like seven. And I really got into it. I started bowling at 8, and the rest is history. Okay. And it was Paradise Lanes in Brooklyn,
wow,
on 4th Avenue and 28th Street.
Wow, Paradise Lanes in Brooklyn, that's going back. First ball, you remember what it was?
Geez, no, I don't. It was a plastic, I don't even know if it was plastic or rubber.
Was it maybe like a Manhattan rubber?
Maybe, yeah. Maybe, okay. Yeah.
Are there any stories about our good friend Joe Snake Lorenzo that you could tell us that are clean now?
Well, I could tell you a lot of stories, but we might be here for about 5 hours.
Just give us one quick one. Just give us a quick one from back in the Brooklyn days.
Well, I got to say one thing about Snake. He was the funniest guy on the lanes, okay? He had more one-liners than anybody. And he was just entertaining, you know, no matter if he was bowling or if he was in the background, yeah. You had a laugh.
Yeah.
He was one of the characters of the game, let
yeah.
me tell you.
Yeah, he definitely was. He was. Snake was. The minute he walked in the bowling alley, no matter where you were, Brooklyn, Staten Island, you knew he was around. How about a shout-out, and where's our friend Rocky Salemo?
I have no idea. The only thing I see is he's always with the horses on Facebook.
Yeah, yeah.
He's always got two girls on his arms.
I guess that's not a bad thing, right? Right, Bob?
I don't know if he pays them to take the picture.
How are you, Rock?
I can say that about Rocky because we go back a long time.
These guys are great, 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 great friends. So tonight we had a little bit of a flashback moment when our good friend Jeff Charest walked in from the Highland Boulevard door. And you said to him, the king is here. The real king is here. So tell us a little bit about that matchup you guys had back many years ago.
Well, back in the 80s when I first started bowling here in 1980. And Dennis will tell you, I always used to say, there's only one king in here, and that was me, right? So, you know, it was a fun thing. You know, I didn't mean any you know, thing about it. So when I saw Jeff, I said to him, don't forget, the real king is here tonight.
That's right. He, as only Jeff could, he stopped wheeling his ball bag. He looked around and he said, where's the king? But you guys had a great matchup in the final of, was it the Donnie Walters tournament? Right? The 1990. Tell us about
it. It was the 13th annual. I was hot that year. That year, I shot 229 average in the league. And back then, 229 was...
Right, with Joey.
Yeah, Joey. Yeah. But anyway, that was like a phenomenal average back then. Because some guys average 220, but like 220, 221. So, and I met Jeff in the finals. And he came out like a gangbuster. You know, he was up the whole match up until the ninth frame. Mm-hmm. And I wound up winning.
Yeah.
And it was a great match.
If you want to see it, it's on YouTube. You got to go back and search for it. It's the Donnie Walters Singles Classic. Or I guess it's the Staten Island Singles Classic, right? And it's on YouTube, 1990. Bob was always the – you remember the ZZ Top song, Everybody's Crazy About a Sharp-Dressed Man? Bobby was always the sharp-dressed man. Always with the black shirt, the black slacks, always dressed to the nines. Jeff had the mullet back then. He had those on, right? You know, kind of like the balloon pants, right? Kind of, right? Yeah, they were all like, yeah. They were hot back then. Even I had a pair.
We used to call them the crazy pants. Yeah.
That's right, the crazy pants. So, Bob, before I bring Joey in, what was your... what was one of your, and this is not to offend any of your opponents from over the years, but tell me what you think outside of that match against Jeff, what do you think was probably one of your toughest matches in all the years that you bowled head-to-head?
In a tournament or action?
Probably action. You know what? I'm going to say both. Give me one tournament and give me one action.
Tournament.
Outside of the Jeff match.
I'm going to say when I lost to Rob Vinci. He was a tough bowler. Yeah,
He's the original. He'll actually be here in about 10 minutes. So.
Yeah, he was really good. In action, I would say Rudy Revs.
Rudy Revs.
Yeah.
Those are some classic names. You might have to tag him in it. But, yep. Now, Rob Vinci is also a league mate of ours. Rob is a Staten Island Bowling Hall of Famer. Rob, back in the day, was another guy with the mullet. I bowled against Rob starting probably like 1988, 89 in the Rocky Foss League here on Sunday morning. Rob, we had guys like Carmine Proetti and Frank Passaro, Steve Bova, a lot of guys from back in the day. That's going back. Rob was probably one of the better guys here too, probably in the top three.
Well, he won the Staten Island Singles Classic three times.
Yes, he did.
Yeah, he was a tough bowler, tough bowler.
He was. So,
and he was a good spare shooter.
He still is.
Yeah.
Rob's the devil. Wait, is he here?
There he is!
The mop! There he is! He's not. And Red Baronello, another legend. Right on cue. We mentioned Rob Vinci. You just got a shout out. You just got a shout out.
Just gave you a shout out. What's going on?
Hey, guys. He just named you one of his toughest opponents.
His toughest opponent in a tournament, Rob Vinci. I bowl with the original mop. He's still good. Bob, that was perfect timing.
Yes, it was. Yeah.
You were his toughest tournament match ever, and Rudy Rev's toughest action match ever. Did you ever bowl Rudy?
I bowled Rudy in the first time I ever bowled for money was the boomerang at Maple Lanes.
Oh, okay.
You bowl across each thing. Yep. I don't know who the guy is. He's just some goofy fat guy. I was like, oh, I could beat that guy. Right? I beat him. Yeah. It was a miracle. When I found out later who he was, you know.
Was that back in the mullet days when you had the mullet?
I had some hair. I did have some hair.
I can relate to that, Rob. But Bobby, those are some spot-on answers, as I knew. And I just want to give a quick shout out to Bobby's wife, Jody. Your handsome husband did a great job, Jody. Just as we thought he was going to. A great job. And don't worry, Dennis is keeping an eye on him. It's okay. So Joey, come on in for your round of questions for the legend, Bobby Spallone.
Thank you, Joe. Bobby Spallone. Imagine this. We have Bobby Spallone here. Very influential in my bowling because the very first year, you want to leave up? The very first year, I picked up a ball Sunday night mix. My friend said, we're going to bowl the second half of this league. So I went, I grabbed my father's U-dot. And I said, yeah, this fits because we had a similar hand. Didn't really know much about bowling. So I came down and I was bowling. I think I averaged 174 for the second half. And this guy comes over to me at one point. He says, hey, why don't you bowl with us next year? You look like, you know, maybe you have some improvement. So I went home and I said, Dad, some guy, Bobby Spallone, asked me to bowl. He's like, Bobby Spallone asked you to bowl. So the very next year, I was ready to take the next step. And Bobby taught me a lot, Joe. He really did. Let's go over some of the things he taught me. First of all, he dressed good. If you noticed, do I ever come in here? I'm always dressed. I got off my golf attire the last few years because I stopped playing golf. But whenever I did bowl, I was always looked like I was golfing. People used to say, would you come from the course? I said, no, this is how I dress because of Bobby. The second thing is Bobby's release and delivery was definitely older school. Smooth, slow follow through. I'm going to say that, believe it or not, when Jeff and Rob came on the scene, they brought a different kind of cranking. They brought a cranking mentality, which was not him. They brought power. So I was bowling with him. So that's all I knew. And it just stuck, you know. It didn't work. But it stuck. But I was there for the Jeff and Bobby. Bobby almost kind of made Jeff because they had trash talking going. He was an 18-year-old kid. Right, and he was mouthing off with the best, and it kind of hardened him up. Even though Bobby was still better, Jeff will tell you different. He's right. He averaged upper 220s, but Jeff at the time was 220 to 225 with a U2, you know, going up five, right? And that's pretty damn good. And I'm going to tell you, in that same league where Bobby and Jeff are going at it every week, Kevin Rourke bowled in it, and Kevin was like 2-0, just on the scene, too, just learning. And now look how far it came. You know, so Kevin wasn't at 220 when those two were going at it at 220. Then he caught up to them. Well, then later on, I got hooked up with my king. My very first 300, 1994, Mike was on my team and talked me through it, him and Bobby Cluck. I'll never forget that as long as I live. I didn't know what I was doing. Well, he was like, just relax. Just keep coming out of it the same way.
I remember the year you bowled with me. You bowled 290. If you remember.
Oh, there you go.
And that was your high game.
Right. Correct.
Yeah.
And you see, he remembered that.
Yeah, I remember that.
I went from 174 to 189 in 1 year, 15 pins up. And then I guess, you know, it started to go up. But I owe Bobby a lot. But the bowling community writes us fan mail. Yep. Stacked this high every week. Me and Joe go through it.
Did you guys want me to get fan mail?
We go through it on Thursdays, and people want to know questions from our legends. The first one that pops up is soon to be. What was your first car, Bobby Spallone?
61 Chevy Impala.
What color?
Blue.
Very nice. What was your first job?
My first job, I worked as a vendor in Shea Stadium and Yankee Stadium.
What year was that?
19. I had to be 14, so 1966.
Okay, so the Mets started getting better there.
They're
starting, just starting.
And the Yankees look bad then.
Yeah, I call those the good old days. So, the bowling community, Love Boat or Fantasy Island?
Excuse me, say that again?
Love Boat or Fantasy Island, which was better?
Fantasy Island.
There you go. See, a lot of people just go with old Love Boat. It's, you got to step out a little. How about Happy Days or Laverne and Shirley?
Happy Days.
Honeymooners or The Odd Couple?
The Honeymooners. I love The Honeymooners.
So do I, and so does Joe. You sure do make a short one. How about tomorrow night? So. Wait, what? Bar up. Hello, ball. What am I playing? Couple, Mr. Marshall, or Mountain Goat? Right, Joe? So. Others. What is it? Dininos or Lees we like to go with?
Lees.
Lees. Plain or do we get toppings on our pizza?
Toppings.
Toppings. All right. Clam pie, Rob? Okay.
Mom, you gotta try
Have you ever ridden a horse, Bobby Spallone?
Yes. In fact, we were talking about it last night. When I was like 15, we used to take the bus from Brooklyn and go to Clove Lakes and go on the horses.
There you go.
Yeah.
I know it well. Have you ever flown in a helicopter?
Yes, in the service.
Oh, okay.
I was in the Navy. And I went from my ship, the destroyer, to the aircraft carrier and back on a helicopter. It's an experience.
I can imagine. Mike, helicopter, Dennis, both ears. Wow. Not me. What do you want? I mean, look, they have a resume. I got to get mine longer.
The M train, the sea beach line, every day to go to work.
Bob, think about it. What is your favorite album of all time? You can go all the way back.
Oh, wow, that's a hard one.
Something you really, really wore out.
Probably the White Album by the Beatles.
Good answer. Nice. And what are we listening to nowadays, Bobby Spallone?
I'm just listening to Sirius FM. I put the 60s on, the 70s. You know.
I'm looking at Bobby right now. He might be the best looking bowler. Ken, I'm sorry, but he's away now. Ralph, this guy. He might be the best looking of all time. Ken, you're damn good, though, Ken. Let's go with a cup just to finish up. Do you have your own Netflix account? Or are you borrowing somebody's?
No, I don't have it.
Oh, you don't? All right. No. All right, Joe, come on in. I need you to go. Two more questions for Bobby as I get together. Lowe's Bowler of the Week, ladies and gentlemen. Sponsored by Lowe's Home Improvement. 78 bowlers. This bowler that I'm about to announce was the lowest in the league last week. Joe.
All right. Get the envelope out. Sure. We're going to go with the Lowe's Bowler of the Week momentarily. A couple more questions for my friend Bob. Bob, now that you're doing the retiree thing, what's your favorite thing to do on a day? Say, I know every day is a Saturday for you now, right? So you wake up, and what's your favorite thing? What's a perfect day for our friend Bobby Spallone?
Well, I play a lot of cards. I play Texas Hold'em, Omaha, Gin Rummy. I tried to go back to bowling, but didn't work out. Threw my back out again.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I miss it. I really miss bowling.
Yeah.
You know, so.
The bowling community misses you, too. And if Snake is watching, he's not inviting you down there to play cards, just so you know, okay? He's playing cards with his friends down in Florida. You're not invited, but we love you, Snake. And, Bobby, last question I have is, if you had to take one part of the game from yesteryear and bring back today, what would be the one thing that you'd like to see today's bowlers? And I don't mean guys like us that have been bowling for a long time. Some of the new breed, some of the junior bowlers, what would you like to see one thing them, what should they be faced with? Something that you, well, yeah, I mean, I'm kind of, what is the one thing that you want to see brought back?
Well, in the old days, you had to be accurate, and you had to be a good spare shooter because the scores weren't that high back then. So that's one thing, you know. Plus, you had to have discipline. You had to have self-control. If you were bowling bad, don't get mad because that's only going to make it worse.
Right, that's right.
You know, and you had to try to get through that struggle when you had a bad game and come back the next game and bowl good.
Yeah, that's right.
And that's what I hope a lot of the junior bowlers out there, and we have speaking of bevy, we have a bevy of good junior bowlers around here, and I hope they're all listening. You got to stay calm. I try to tell them when I coach them, don't get excited. You got to stay calm. You throw a bad shot, you leave it out there. Just like Bobby Spallone said, some discipline and make your spares. And Joe, you ready for the Lowe's bowler?
I got it right here.
Before you come in, just one quick thing. A lot of us in this room, and I'm glad Bobby gave that answer, our dads were the ones that got us started with the game. I know the three of us. I'm sure some of the guys in here too, their dads, maybe their moms got them started. And here's a tidbit. Mike King, Melody Lanes in 1960. He mentioned it last night. My grandfather, my father's father, was the manager at Melody Lanes in the late 50s and the early 60s. So my grandpa was probably the guy that gave Mike the lane. You never know.
That's great.
And look at him now. Anyway, Joe, come on in.
Well, what other sport could you bowl with your dad on the same team or against him? You play golf with them. Those memories you want to last forever. My father got me started in this, and I'm still here.
Yep.
Now I got a microphone and being a complete clown. But you know what? Joe and I decided we got to make this fun, and that's what we do every week. But we still compete. Lowe's Bowler of the Week is going to a friend of ours.
A friend of the show.
Ladies and gentlemen, Marco Recchia, 550. Congratulations. The pizza man completely lost last week. 160, 180, 190, whatever the hell it was. Horrendous. We love you, Marco. Bobby, what percentage of hands do you play from the button? Over 50?
No, under 50.
Rob, is he right?
Is he right what? Does he play them?
How about you?
Good strategy.
How about you?
Mine's a lot higher.
Okay.
Well, you're playing a lot of cards. It's good, though. I admit it. I love it, too. I still love it. You still play it all? All right, good. So we love Rob, too. Ladies and gentlemen, Bobby Spallone was in Studio 710 with us. One of my biggest honors and one of my biggest inspirations in this sport, along with Mike King in the back. Put the camera on Mike King. Taught me a lot in this sport. And my boy Dennis Rigatti, one of the funniest jokes ever, when he put his finger on the top of his head and he made fun of Joe Altieri's revs. It was unbelievable that night. Joe was teasing him. And Dennis just, man, it was great. Great stuff. All right, send them off, Joe.
All right. So a big thank you to our friend Bob Spallone again. Bob, thank you so much.
Listen, thank you for having me on. It's an honor. It's a pleasure.
The pleasure's ours, but thank you, Bob.
Believe me, I'm very, very...
Thank you. Thank you. And tonight, we're going to go out there. We're going to lace them up, and we're going to bowl in front of some of our idols and our friends, like Bob Spallone and Mike King and Dennis Rigatti. And I don't know if these guys are going to do it, but last night, I don't think Bobby's in on this, but Mike and Dennis said they're here tonight to heckle Kevin Rourke. So if Kevin Rourke has an off game, they're going to ride him hard tonight. They're going to heckle him. So, but anyway, folks, we're going to send it off like we always do. We don't know who our guest is going to be yet for next week. We like to surprise people this year, okay? Like we had our surprise with our friend Bob. But we're going to send it off with, because we got to go practice. Good night, good luck, God bless, and good bowling.